In a year like no other, you made it, and we're very proud of you. Congratulations. Best wishes to all of our graduates. Hail to Pitt.
Congratulations to the class of 2021. This has been an extraordinary year. You showed grit and resilience getting through it, and I know that will carry you through to a great career and a great life ahead. Hail to Pitt.
To the class of 2021, you did it, persevering through these incredibly difficult times with complete style. Congratulations to each of you, and my very best wishes for your next adventure.
Dear class of 2021, thank you so much for your partnership in getting us all through so successfully through these challenging times. Congratulations and best wishes.
Congratulations to the class of 2021. We are proud of you. You've achieved amazing outcomes in a very troubled time. And as you think about your next career moves, keep Pitt IT in mind.
We are so proud and happy for you. And we know that you are ready to take on the world. Go and make a difference. Hail to Pitt.
Congratulations to the class of 2021. If you can do this, you can do anything. You are all going to be incredibly successful in whatever you do next. Hail to Pitt.
Congratulations, class of 2021. We're proud of you and can't wait to watch you change the world. Hail to Pitt.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You did some amazing things. You got through your classes, you defeated the pandemic, and you created a world that recognizes justice. So thank you so much, and great path forward for all of your careers. Thank you.
Congratulations and best wishes for a very fulfilling career. Hail to Pitt.
Class of 2021, what an amazing achievement. Big things are ahead for each and every one of you. Can't wait to see you back on campus. Hail to Pitt.
Congratulations, class of 2021. May you go on to do phenomenal things and be reminded that great works are performed not only by strength, but by perseverance. Hail to Pitt.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You are prepared to take on the world and do amazing things with your Pitt degree. I want to wish you the best of luck in all of your future endeavors, and remember to always lift as you climb.
Congratulations!
Splashing in a summer stream, tripping, I fall in. I wanted it to.
Hey, Panthers. I know you've heard a lot from me in the past year, reminding you to mask up and follow Pitt's health and safety guidelines and shelter in place and keep through your pods and all that. But today, I have a very different message. It brings me great joy to say, congratulations, you made it. You've shown the world and yourselves that you are resilient, determined, and courageous in the midst of uncertainty and change. I hope you take some time to feel proud of your achievements and enjoy this important milestone with friends and family. As a Pitt alumnus, you are part of the Pitt family for life. Congratulations.
Good evening. It is my honor to welcome all graduate candidates and their guests here today, along with our candidates and guests watching from home, to the commencement convocation celebrating the Kenneth P. Dietrich School of Arts and Sciences, the School of Education, the Graduate School of Public Health, the Graduate School of Public and International Affairs, and the School of Computing and Information. As University Marshal of the University of Pittsburgh, I declare this commencement convocation open. Please welcome members of the Academic Administration, our two graduate candidate speakers, Ms. Jaskia Jones and Ms. Marta Bochom, Senior Vice Chancellor for the Health Sciences and John and Gertrude Peterson Dean, School of Medicine, Dr. Anantha Shekhar, Provost and Senior Vice Chancellor, Dr. Ann Cudd, and Chancellor of the University of Pittsburgh, Dr. Patrick Gallagher.
The Academy Awards, you have to wait for that music to stop, right? So as Chancellor of the University of Pittsburgh, it is my very distinct pleasure and honor to welcome our distinguished guests, our families, and our friends to our 2021 graduate commencement ceremony. But most of all, I'm delighted to welcome our students, our graduates of the University of Pittsburgh today. Because whether you're here in person or whether you're joining us virtually, this is something we weren't sure that was going to happen, and I'm thrilled to welcome you to our commencement ceremony. You know, this is probably the most number of people I've seen in a long time. and I don't think I realized until this very moment how much it would mean to me to see all of you here with us today. I think I speak for everyone when I say that even wearing these masks, you Pitt graduate students are a sight for sore eyes. We are so glad to be here with you today because this is one of the moments that we live for. This is why we're here in the Academy. We get to share our passion for knowledge and discovery, for teaching and learning, and with bright minds such as yourselves, we get to work together to advance this mission every day. So on a day like this, when we gather as a community to say, you've done it, you worked, you sacrificed, You grew in profound ways, I hope both personally and professionally. And perhaps at times you doubted that you could make it to this day, but now this accomplishment is yours and it will last forever. I could not be more proud of this group of Pitt students. And I look forward to seeing you back here for years to come as proud fellow alumni of the University of Pittsburgh. As we celebrate you and your achievements today, we are very aware that you did not get here alone. The faculty, and especially your advisors, have believed in you and challenged you and supported you. Pitt staff members have also supported your success in their many roles. And of course, your families and loved ones have been there for you, cheered you on, picked you up when you were down, and loved you and supported you every step of the way. So before we get started, I'd like to ask all the students to stand up, and I would like to ask all of us here to give them a standing ovation as our expression of our support to them. Okay, don't get worn out, because we're going to do it at the end when we congratulate them. I feel like we're at a Penguins game, a sparse but mighty audience here. Now, we do have a special message for all of you, the graduates of 2021, from our University of Pittsburgh Board of Trustees. So if you turn your attention to the video.
On behalf of the Board of Trustees, let me extend a hearty and enthusiastic congratulations to the graduating class of 2021. Your perseverance in the face of incredible complexity and adversity has been an inspiration to all of us. You've once again made Pitt proud.
Congratulations!
Hail to Pitt!
Now this evening, I have the honor of introducing your commencement speaker, who will join us virtually. But it is a real pleasure for me to introduce Dr. Deborah Bogan. She is she earned her medical degree from the University of Colorado School of Medicine. She completed a pediatric residency and fellowship at Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore. And after many years here at Pitt, as a professor of pediatrics and a physician at Children's Hospital of Pittsburgh, she was nominated and then confirmed as director of the Allegheny County Health Department on March 4th, 2020. Now, if you think back to March 2020, you realize what was about to happen. So her very first day on the job was actually supposed to be 2 months after that date, but it became clear within days of her nomination that as the first cases of COVID-19 began to appear locally, and as you all know, we began our own depopulation of the campus and our own response to this pandemic. And so her start became even sooner than she expected, and she took the helm of the health department within days of her confirmation. I'm sure for her, this was not the experience she was expecting. But in response to this urgent health crisis and over the following year, it was her steady, calm, and science-based leadership that has been so important to this region successfully navigating through this pandemic. You know, here at the University of Pittsburgh, we've long valued our close partnership with the Allegheny County Health Department, but 2020 demanded a rapid acceleration and intensification of that partnership. And together, we have done some amazing things. Pitt and the Allegheny Health Department have together vaccinated thousands of people, starting with community members, but then extending to our own Pitt family, our faculty, staff, and students, many of you perhaps here today, many of you perhaps vaccinated in this very building. We've partnered to ensure that university students have the information and the resources they need to keep themselves, their friends, and their community safe. And we've worked together every day, as you well know, to minimize the spread of the disease while we carry out our mission. And above all, it's a partnership that has allowed the Pitt community to do what we are here to do, to teach, to learn, to conduct research, to make the world a better place through knowledge, and to never stop moving forward, even during a pandemic. It is for that reason and for that partnership and for the exemplary leadership of Dr. Bogan that the University of Pittsburgh will be forever grateful. And on a personal note, I just want to say, you know, I think I speak with Dr. Bogan probably every week during this whole pandemic. And I can't tell you how many times her thoughts turn to the students and looking for ways that we can support what you were doing here. So her Pitt roots and her Pitt experience were very clear to all of us. I would ask you to join me in please welcoming your commencement speaker, Dr. Deborah Bogan.
Greetings, University of Pittsburgh graduate students. Congratulations on this important achievement in your professional and personal journey. I am so deeply humbled and frankly a bit anxious to speak to you today. This is my first time being a commencement speaker. Thank you for this opportunity. It's really a great honor. Over the next few minutes, I'd like to describe to you my yellow brick road philosophy, which argues that rewarding careers and personal paths do not follow a straight, well-defined road, but rather a winding yellow brick road, fueled by passion and influenced by the many people you meet along the way. Allow me to set the stage. In The Wizard of Oz, Dorothy finds herself in an unfamiliar place, lost, confused, and searching to find her way. Fortunately for her, she encounters strangers who become friends and mentors who then lead her down the path by helping her follow the yellow brick road. That road was not a direct, straight line. It curved. It brought her and her companions to unexpected places, physically, emotionally, and intellectually. And that's important. Some people may tell you to pick a goal in life and pursue it single-mindedly without distraction. I suggest to you that the destination can and often does change, and that the journey itself offers an endless supply of adventure, plus lessons to learn from those who travel with you. Take Dorothy. She encounters a variety of impactful people on her meandering road. There's the Tin Man, who demonstrates the importance of having heart or passion in your work. I learned that firsthand years ago when I was starting my clinical research fellowship. I had selected a research topic and dove into the literature. A month or so in, when I met with my fellowship director and she asked me how my background reading was progressing, I sighed and admitted that it put me to sleep. She asked to see the folder of reading materials in front of me, and she unceremoniously threw them in the trash. If the reading was putting me to sleep, she explained, the chosen topic was wrong for me. She encouraged me to find an area of research that excited me. I embraced that advice and have passed it on myself many times. Passion is what I look for in job applicants and coworkers because that energy or heart is contagious. The scarecrow, who seeks the brain he has all along, plays the role of knowledge sharer. Meeting people with expertise in a new area of exploration is essential. Along my career in industry, academia, and public service, many mentors and colleagues have shared their knowledge, and in turn, I shared mine as it developed. It is a give and take, which I hope you have already experienced during your time as graduate students. The lion teaches the importance of risk-taking. As mentioned, the road Dorothy and her companions followed was not straight, but had many twists and turns, which can provide opportunity should you have the courage to follow them and see where they take you. Glinda, the good witch, sprinkles the world with kindness, provides Dorothy and her companions with moral support, and demonstrates the importance of clear communication by providing directions to follow the yellow brick road. I have been blessed with many Glindas along my yellow brick road, and I try to be a Glinda to others by acting in a way that supports the development and provides opportunity for growth. Finally, there's the imperfect Wizard of Oz himself, who despite his obvious flaws, ultimately displays kindness and helps Dorothy open doors for Dorothy. The wizard teaches us all that opportunity can be hidden in the most unexpected and unusual places. Like Tin Man, it is important to follow your passion, and like Lion, to couple courage with wisdom, and like Dorothy, to seek support and guidance from others, and to impart it in equal measure, and to find traveling companions who can help determine if turns in the road are opportunities for growth and development or obstacles and distractions. Careful selection of timely opportunities can lead to new knowledge, adventure, and fulfillment. Detours in the road helped Lion discover his courage, Scarecrow his brain, and Tin Man his heart. On the other hand, some opportunities are more like Dorothy's detour to the poppies, where she fell asleep and loses ground. There are countless ways to give back to your community, to learn and develop, to help others, and you must stay open to following new paths if you wish to discover them and the people who can guide you. Ask yourself, what are your values, your principles, your passions, your goals? Knowing these is far more important than knowing exactly where you want to end up. This year, my path twisted in a new direction. After nearly a quarter of a century, I left behind a fulfilling career in academia at the University of Pittsburgh to pursue public health and public service. I didn't know what challenges lay hidden down the path, but I knew I wanted to serve and give back to my community, and this was an opportunity to do so. Like the lion, I never thought of myself as courageous, and taking this position amidst an impending global pandemic was scary. While 10 years ago, I may never have pictured myself where I am today, I can look to the new relationships I've developed, the skills I've learned, those who have guided me, and those I've guided in return, and I hope the impact I've had on people's lives, and know that this twist in the path, unforeseen and unplanned, has been worthwhile. Staying true to your values will lead you through turbulent times, through unknowns and challenges that will push you. It can be easy to keep your eyes down on the path in front of you and never look up, never meet new faces, never build community, never take a new branch in the road. But if you do that, you'll be missing so much. I'm so grateful for everyone who has walked with me on my journey, the loved ones, mentors, colleagues who have supported me when I followed curious side paths and nudged me back in the right direction when the time came for the journey to continue. Now your journey continues. I wish you all interesting and rewarding travels as you follow your own yellow brick roads and sprinkle your own knowledge, passion, and kindness to others along the way. So, with that, congratulations and hail to Pitt.
Thank you, Dr. Bogan, for those thoughtful and inspiring words. I'd now like you to join me in welcoming one of our graduate candidates to the podium, Jazkia Jones. Jazkia?
Thank you, Chancellor Gallagher. Good evening. First, I want to say congratulations to my fellow graduates. The time, effort, long nights, random tears, venting sessions, and countless, is this even worth it, has helped get you to these seats. I am proud of you. When I had an interview with Vice Provost Gottlieb for commencement speaker, I stated I wanted to talk about the power of the present moment, how we should all remember that we cannot stress ourselves into the future. She asked if I planned on talking about the multiple pandemics occurring, COVID-19 and pervasive racism. I said no. I did not want to spend much time on such traumatic moments on a day of celebration. Then came April 20, 2021. Our country celebrated justice for the family of George Floyd with the guilty verdict of Derek Chauvin. And in the same 24 hours, many of us mourned the unnecessary murder of Micaiah Bryant, a Black child shot by the police. It was a bittersweet day. Truthfully, this year has been bittersweet. We have lost the lives of loved ones, been exposed to fear and trauma frequently, worried about our current or future jobs, and watched as our sense of normality vanished. However, we have also relearned the value of life, relationships, and yes, the power of the present. Where we are right now is worth remembering. The intensity we feel in our bodies and souls, the joy, enthusiasm, restlessness, anger, fear, sadness, the pull to do more and nothing at the same time. This present moment right now and each single day moving forward deserves a chance to be experienced with our whole beings. As we walk this stage and enter our life's next chapter, it is important to remember that tomorrow has its own set of possibilities. We can dream and plan for the outcomes, but we cannot predict the future. It is in our actions in this exact moment of delight and despair that are most valuable. Take a second and enjoy this moment. Breathe deeply, or as deeply as our mask will allow. Look around you and meet new faces. Most of all, take this day, right now, and rejoice, for this moment was once a dream, and your hard work and tenacity brought you along. You did it, whether it was according to your initial plans or not. Every moment must be appreciated for its rareness. If we are always stressing for the future, we will miss the beauty of the present. Life is scary, but the magnificence of the right now gives us hope to persevere, one step at a time. I close with a quote from the late, great Chadwick Boseman. Look down over what you've conquered and appreciate what has brought you through. Thank you.
Thank you, Jessica. That was terrific. I'd now like to ask you to join me in welcoming graduate degree candidate Marta Bochon to the podium. Marta?
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for being here with us today. Just a second. All right, we good. There are two main reasons why I wanted to be this year's graduation speaker. First, I want to thank the people who have contributed to our success today, but who unfortunately very often stay in the shadows and do not receive the gratitude and praise they deserve. Therefore, I want to dedicate this speech tonight to the University of Pittsburgh Student Health Services, dear doctors, nurses, therapists, and counselors, for all the work they have done for all of us throughout our time at Pitt. They were there for us when we were losing our hope, strength, and belief. And personally, they were there for me, providing me with guidance, understanding, and encouragement. The second part of my speech constitutes a message to all current and future graduate students. I do believe, and I strongly believe, that I am not the only one who has been experiencing a rather bumpy road toward my PhD. But here I am at the finish line. I am bruised but not broken, knocked down but never knocked out. I often wondered why this is the case, that despite everything I kept on going. Recently, I was told that it's up to us what we make out of the pain, suffering, and heartbreak we experience in our personal and professional lives. One way to go, we can let them destroy us. But what instead we use them to our advantage and let them empower us? Then we gain determination, stamina, and strength like never before. Our mindset becomes that of a fighter, and all of a sudden we are capable of achieving great things. I believe that today you are taking home much more than a degree. I do believe that you are taking home an invisible suit that yet makes you invincible. The suit is not made out of iron or vibranium, but from an even stronger substance. I believe it's made from the heart and mind of a warrior, because that's what I think we all are. Therefore, I want to congratulate you, not particularly on your PhD, but I want to congratulate you on your journey towards it. Thank you.
Thank you, Martha. Now we're getting into the heart of the matter as we begin the awarding of degrees, and we will begin with the health sciences. We will announce each candidate that is joining us in person, and at the conclusion of the ceremony, the names of all candidates, including those watching virtually, will be announced by video on the commencement website. With that, I'd like you to please join me in welcoming Dr. Anantha Shaker, as we begin awarding the degrees in health sciences.
Good evening, and thank you, Chancellor, and congratulations to each and every one of you. As the Senior Vice Chancellor for the Health Sciences and the Dean of the School of Medicine, it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Maureen Lichtwald, Dean of the Graduate School of Public Health, who will present the candidates.
Good evening, and thank you, Dr. Shaker. It is because of public health that we're here, and it's because of the leadership of Pittsburgh that we're here. And so I haven't heard it loud enough. Hail to Pitt.
Hail to
Pitt. Good. As the Dean of the Graduate School of Public Health, it is my honor to welcome the candidates for the doctoral degree recommended by the faculties of the Graduate School of Public Health to the platform.
Roberta Rees. Congratulations, Dr. Rees. Teresa Anguiano. Congratulations, Dr. Anguiano. Ebisola Onion. Congratulations, Dr. Onyanin. Abdulrahman. Sorry.
Master's degree recommended by the graduate faculties from the Graduate School of Public Health. Master degree candidates.
Abdulrahman Olabird. Hannah Bitzer. Brittany Chamberlain. Tatiana Pomerantz. Ms. Holti Williams. Daniel Evans. Haley Koulas. Kia Kai. Lauren Gutterman. Shannon Mitchell. Trinity Sprague. Julia Groh. Lindsay Spiker. Marielle Anling. Megan Chahalski. Devin Strinkowski. Elizabeth Hassett. Kavya Hurrier. Ashleya Krupa. Nellie Cariza. Ramya Saravanan. Naveen Suresh Babu. Vashali Moraldian.
My pleasure now to call on our Senior Vice Chancellor and Provost, Dr. Ann Cutt.
Good evening and congratulations, graduates. As the Provost and Senior Vice Chancellor, it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. John Twining, Associate Dean from the Kenneth P. Dietrich School of Arts and Sciences and the College of General Studies, who will present the candidates.
Thank you, Provost Card, and good evening, everyone. Please welcome the candidates for the doctoral degree recommended by the graduate faculties from the Kenneth P. Dietrich School of Arts and Sciences.
Marta Bozon. Congratulations, Dr. Bozon. Jacob Spiegel. Congratulations, Dr. Spiegel. Alana Fields. Congratulations, Dr. Fields. Sarah Kennedy. Congratulations, Dr. Kennedy. Amanda Jane Olmsted. Congratulations, Dr. Olmsted. Hui Hu. Congratulations, Dr. Hu. Jeffrey Weston. Congratulations, Dr. Weston. Ryan Bala. Congratulations, Dr. Bala. Haoran Zhang. Congratulations, Dr. Song. Hui Peng. Congratulations, Dr. Peng. Woodrow Steinken. Congratulations, Dr. Steinken. Cody Spinner. Congratulations, Dr. Spinner. Qing Yi Gan. Congratulations, Dr. Gan. Ariana Brazier. Congratulations, Dr. Brazier. Arliam Kalaprova. Congratulations, Dr. Karapalova. Shreya Ghosh. Congratulations, Dr. Ghosh. Tatiana Schlinkar. Congratulations, Dr. Schlinkar. Kimberly Hoover. Congratulations, Dr. Hoover. Ambrose Curtis. Congratulations, Dr. Curtis.
Thank you. Please now welcome the candidates for master's degree recommended by the graduate faculties from the Kenneth P. Dietrich School of Arts and Sciences.
Spencer Siegel. Xinyu Chang.
It is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Amanda Godley, Vice Provost for Graduate Studies and Professor, School of Education, who will present the candidates.
Thank you, Provost Cudd. Please welcome the candidates for the doctoral degrees and professional doctoral degrees recommended by the graduate faculties from the School of Education.
John G. Rozilowicz.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Dr. Rozilowicz. Valeria McCray. Congratulations, Dr. McCray. Stephanie Feely. Congratulations, Dr. Feely. Heather Black.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Dr. Black. Lauren Maria. Congratulations, Dr. Maria. Jamie Loosbrink. Congratulations, Dr. Lou Spring. Toya Jones. Congratulations, Dr. Jones. Hamsini Rajagopal. Congratulations, Dr. Rajagopal. Ryan Cosella. Congratulations, Dr. Cosella. Catherine Favo. Congratulations, Dr. Favo. Gina Matusi. Congratulations, Dr. Matusi. Mary Elias. Congratulations, Dr. Elias. Emily Murphy. Congratulations, Dr. Murphy. Lauren Wright. Congratulations, Dr. Wright. Megan Nelson. Congratulations, Dr. Nelson. Shanae Jeffrey. Congratulations, Dr. Jeffrey. Anessa Bontrager. Congratulations, Dr. Bontrager. Trisha Cousins. Congratulations, Dr. Cousins. Brittany Weatherspoon.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Dr. Weatherspoon. Dr. Tracy Bowman. Congratulations, Dr. Bowman.
And now, please welcome the candidates for the master's degrees recommended by the graduate faculties from the School of Education.
Jezkia Jones. Pope Rice. Aaron Simonson. Mariana Gutierrez. Danielle Manros. Carolyn Foster. Allison Colo. Rachel Denon. Jenny Kaufman. Carly Schaub. Lene Lombardi. Cooper Sheely. David Gadala. Chelsea Hancock. William Wesley. Catherine Ickes. Amelia Jaffe. Kaylee Caulfield. Tom Moran. Julia Ellis. Alfonsa Lily Amuda Amalagiam. Alex Mears. Michael Zeeler. Kelsey Edmonds Tyndall. Mark Craven. Simeon McCrary. Carla Perlstein. Hussein Kanbe. Marcy Jamadia. Michael Lewis. Melissa Benfer. Hannah Greer. Chris Abbott. Stephen Thomas. Kurt Voshoynes. Kristen Shannon. Connor Thompson. Caitlin Shreve. Ryan Ott. Allison Krasick. Christopher Kovalik. Christian Custodio Melendez. Brittany Larkin. Abby Gifford. Robert Eastwood. Eleni Brown. Isabel Crane. Melinda Condisco. Weston Phillips. Hannah Berg. Ashley Pop. Aaron Callback. Julia Buss. Hannah Cristofano. Taylor Looney. Megan Hugo. Kara Piacelli. Laura Prisbyla. Bryce Potts. Monica Yang. Patricia DiCenzo. Sophia Sansone. Lauren Skillinge. Tori Hogendonner. Amanda Sims. Caitlin Bodnar. Devin Yapsuga. Taylor Cole. Sophie Shaw. Maureen Hannigan. Melanie Flores. Mark Killinger. Jessica Goldberg. Emily Baranek. Nazia Shafiq. Savannah Knoll. Hannah Phillips. Michaela Mahoney. Cameron Barnett. Rebecca Tarullo. Taylor Crosby.
It is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Clarissa Slaughterback, Dean of the Graduate School of Public and International Affairs.
Thank you, Provost Cudd. Please welcome the candidate for the doctoral degree recommended by the graduate faculties of the Graduate School of Public and International Affairs.
Hovhannes Nahaptian. Congratulations, Dr. Nahaptian. Tegan Masugu.
Please welcome the candidates for the master's degree recommended by the graduate faculties from the Graduate School of Public and International Affairs.
Congratulations, Dr. Masugu. Jillian Royal. Wenceslas Rumangan. Chidinma Onua. Nora Lopez Cruz. Rebecca Holland. Alexandria Smith. Gabrielle Murata. Mitchell Powell. Fallon Weedman. Zoe Birch. Matthew Pribis. Timofey Karasov. Palumi Olugbenga. Andrea Stanford. Ai Yunan An. Kayla Conforti. Josephine Searing. Carla Nasanu Alcides. Zara Ganadian. Laura Gooding. Lisa Sapusik. Spencer Pilak. Andrew Miller. Paul Gibson. Eleanor Malarski. Jasmine Randolph Taylor. Cameron Hoffman. Cameron Lumley. Molly Penderville. Joel Maddox. Ryan Peters. Daniel Pratt. Aaron Sims. Brian Baer. Alice Najimi. Alexander Romeo. Annalise McCarthy. Sarah McDougall. Soon Il Lee. Hegan Lee. Paige Need. Hope Finch. Timothy Kim.
It is my pleasure to now introduce Dr. Adam Lee, Associate Dean for the School of Computing and Information.
Thank you, Provost Cudd. Please welcome the candidates for the doctoral degree recommended by the graduate faculties from the School of Computing and Information.
Mohammed Hazendea Mofran. Congratulations, Dr. Hazendea Mofran.
Congratulations.
Debashish Ganguly.
Now say it.
Congratulations, Dr. Ganguly.
Please welcome the candidates for the master's degrees recommended by the graduate faculties from the School of Computing and Information.
Justin Kramer. Linda Jones. Thomas DiCarlo. Shi Chen Zhang. Che Su Chu. Zach Habel. Hugh Liu. Chunqi Liao. Shang Zhuha. Qian Tian Lu. Hugh Yong Chi. Fang Sang Gao. Zhu Min Yang. Zi Qing Gao. Zi-Yi Huang. Si-Shi Ji. Xiao Chan. Jingji Zhu. Tian Zhang. Yangjing Wang. Xia Lu. Suryadeepan Lakshmashirman. Vamshi Busa. Akhil Solomankala. Srinivas Gautam Upalapati. Om Patel. Sweta Bhutendra Rawal. Devdas Ghosh. Sapradeep Perry. Kikaraj Kakandar. Nikunj Goel. Rachita Jain. Pew Malik. Shruti Gupta. Sandhindra Kusami. Yi Chen Cha. Ishwarya Jaka. Sankal Mathur. Shubrika Singhal. Tejavsi Meedi. Sanil Vartek.
This concludes the recognition of the candidates.
Congratulations. Today is the day when you receive your diploma that Pitt becomes stitched to your very soul for life. Thank you for the privilege of choosing us and letting us be a part of your lives. And of course, hail to Pitt.
Hail to Pitt.
Congratulations on receiving a degree from a great undergraduate university. You can go anywhere in the world with a degree from Pitt and do anything. I just have one message for you. As you achieve your goals in your career, and as you move forward in your life after Pitt, please find time to serve. So many of us can give to our communities, whether it's public service or any other kind of service. Please find time to serve. God bless you and your family. Thank you.
Hail to Pitt.
Hail to Pitt.
Today you're starting on a journey, the journey you've been working for the past several years. A journey that will take you to many mountaintops and many valleys. And along that time, you have had the opportunity to have learned and to have gained experiences from your time here in Pittsburgh. I hope you'll look back at these times and to help to guide you in recognizing the potential that you have. On behalf of the people of the city of Pittsburgh, congratulations and hail to Pitt.
Hail to Pitt.
We need your talent. We need your energy. We need your drive and your willingness to make things better. And the level of cooperation that you've shown over this last year as part of a broader community dealing with the health pandemic shows your ability and your willingness to adapt. That characteristic is going to be so important as you move forward. We're looking forward to the contributions you will continue to make in this world. Congratulations.
I am so proud of each and every one of you for persisting through a crisis that we have never seen in our lifetimes. In fact, there hasn't been a pandemic for more than over 100 years. But you all have completed school, some of us on Zoom, all of us socially distanced. Yet you've been able to get your group projects done. You've been able to get to the finish line and cross that path, getting to the graduation stage. Congratulations from Harrisburg and continued success in the future.
Congratulations, graduates of University of Pittsburgh. Just go forth, no matter what, just let your light shine. Be encouraged always and always keep it moving. Let that inner light, that wattage shine. Congratulations.
Welcome to a network of alumni that hail from all around the world. We are here to support you and to help you as you embark on your career. Celebrate your success today. It is an amazing accomplishment. Hail to Pitt.
I want to wish you all my deepest congratulations on your graduation. Good luck in your next steps and welcome to our worldwide network of Pitt alumni.
The important thing now is focusing on the great places and achievements waiting for you. So off you go. They are all waiting to be attained by you. Best wishes and all the best to you.
Hail to Pitt, yeah! Man, you all made it, huh? Through elections, through COVID, through at-home classes, to having to be stuck with your mom and dad for your senior year. You made it. Congratulations, and understand that we are all proud of you.
Hey, it's your boy DJ Bonix, proud Pittsburgh Panther alumni, and I gotta say, this is your time to shine. Congratulations, you did it. You crushed it. A big salute to the class of 2021 University of Pittsburgh. Hail Pitt.
I am thrilled to congratulate you on your accomplishments and for achieving this major milestone. As an alum of 50 years, I welcome you to the Pitt community of over 330,000 members and look forward to networking with you. Hail to Pitt.
Congratulations to the Pitt class of 2021. What you do from here will create the very atmosphere for victory or defeat. But with your Pitt education, I know you will be victorious. And as my Pitt friends say, hail to Pitt.
I just want to say congrats to each and every one of the graduates. It's an amazing accomplishment. You've been through some crazy times, but this is just the beginning. And yeah, maybe this isn't the zoo, but there's a whole lot of people cheering for you because it's only going to get better, and this is the beginning. Go get it done.
Well, we've done the diplomas, we've done the speeches. I think it's time to make this official. So this time I'd like to invite Provost Cudd to assist me in the conferral of degrees. Would the platform party please rise?
Would all of the doctoral candidates, the professional doctoral candidates, and those candidates attending virtually please rise?
By the authority vested in me by our university's Board of Trustees, and upon the recommendation of the faculty of your respective schools, I am honored to confer the degree of doctorate with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Will the doctoral and professional doctoral graduates please remain standing? And will the candidates for master's degrees in attendance and those attending virtually please rise?
So once again, by the authority vested in me by our trustees, and upon the recommendation of the faculty of your respective schools, I am honored to confer upon you the degree of master's with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. So the tradition, it's all official now. This is like the, this is the key moment. I want to thank all the graduates, stay standing. Everyone else can be seated. You are now graduates of the University of Pittsburgh. You did it. And as we bid you farewell into your next journey, I want to extend my warmest wishes to you for every success. And remember, you always have a home here at Pitt. I hope you will come back and take advantage of that. I have one last thing to ask our audience, our small but mighty audience. Please join me in being the very first as I introduce the University of Pittsburgh Graduate and Professional Class of 2021.